the shooter fled the scene. Originally, we believed that Shelby County had got behind the scene and had taken the suspect into custody. We have been able to determine that that person is not our suspect. We do have very good information on who our suspect is, and our investigators are working hard to locate that individual right now. I can tell you that the suspect was a black male who fled in a black Mazda SUV.
All right. Was he an employee?
So our preliminary information indicates that he is a former employee of the business, our suspect is.
How long had he been former, do you know?
I don't have that information. You'll have to get that from Walmart.
What about the victim? Are they employed too?
No, the victim is not. He was a customer. It stemmed from a physical altercation between a customer and this former employee.
How serious are the customer's injuries?
He's critical.
Did anyone happen inside the Walmart or outside?
It did happen at the front of the business. So we did get, again, multiple calls. There were multiple shots fired, but it was a targeted incident. It was an altercation between two individuals that led to this shooting.
Did they know each other, or the fight just started inside the store?
So that's going to be information that we're going to look a little bit more into, but at this time, we don't know that they had any previous relationship or acknowledgement of each other.
How many times was he shot, the victim?
I don't have that information.
You said at the front door. Was it inside or outside the front door?
It was inside and outside the front door. So it was like right there in the front of the business.
You don't know what they're fighting about.
Of the suspect?
He's a black male. And he fled in a black Mazda SUV.
A witness told us that the former employee was arguing with his girlfriend. Do you know anything about that at all?
Yes, so I can confirm that he was arguing with a female prior to getting into the argument with the individual that he shot.
And you don't know what they were fighting about?
No, I don't. So I will say that I want to note that Walmart went through their procedures and locked down the store. They got everybody away from the incident that was happening and kept their employees safe, which is great. In an active shooter situation, there are three steps that we really preach, and that's avoid, deny, and defend. We want you to get out of there, deny access to yourself by locking doors or getting in a safe place, and then if the bad guy does get to you, then obviously you take the steps necessary to protect yourself. So they went through those procedures, but this was not an active shooter today. This was an isolated incident, one shooting, one suspect, one victim.
Did the girlfriend leave with the boyfriend?
That's going to be part of the investigation.
So you know who he is, okay.
We do have information on who the suspect is. We're just not able to release that information at this time, but our investigators are working hard to find him.
What's the rest of this investigation look like for y'all? I mean, how long y'all expect to be out here, that kind of thing?
We'll be here for several hours. So our investigators are on the scene now. There are several witnesses that we're going to be interviewing. We're going to have crime scene officers come to document the scene. And then, of course, Walmart's going to have to clean up. Whether they reopen today is going to be a decision made by Walmart.
Is the suspect considered armed and dangerous?
The suspect is armed, but as far as being a threat to the general public, I wouldn't go that far. It looks like this is a targeted incident. That's what our information indicates.
Any idea why he was a former employee?
That's going to be information you have to get from Walmart.
Was he employed at the time of the shooting?
So the time of his termination, of when he was terminated, you'll have to get from Walmart.
Is the scene on I-240 and Airways connected to this?
So that is where the traffic stop was made on the individual that we believe to be part of this incident, but he is not. So that is it's Shelby County scene, but again, that is not our suspect in this case.
Do you know how many people were inside, employees and customers?
I don't have that information. No.
Okay.
All right, guys.
Thank you.
If I get any more while y'all are here, I'll let you know.
Thank you so much.
Councilwoman's here.
A quick statement. Of course, this is in District 2, and we're saddened that these events have taken place in our district. We are thankful for the quick actions of both the Sheriff's Department and the MPD. Homeland Security is on site for the Mobile Crisis Unit for any victims that are still here and need assistance. But I do want to put out, because I know a lot of people left the scenes, both shoppers and other employees, they've already left the scene, that there are counseling services available to them at our Crime Victims and Rape Crisis Center. You can call that number at 901-222-3950. They also have a website and set up time to speak with a counselor if you feel that that's needed. So we want to make sure that all the people that need assistance, that are feeling traumatized and the effects of this, because it's not just about somebody who got shot. The other people who've been here are really shaken up. I've seen them come out today. We want to make sure that they get the help they need as well.